The correct answers were negative 2/3 and positive 3/2. Fantastic work if you found these two answers. Factoring is one of those important skills that will come up again and again. So let's make sure that we know how to do this. I'm going to subtract 5x from both sides and 6 from both sides. I perform the same operation on both sides, and I'm just showing these two steps at once. This leaves me with 0 on the left and 6x squared minus 5x minus 6 on the right. I also know I want to subtract on both sides here since I want the x squared term to have a positive coefficient. It's generally easiest to factor when this term is positive. So I've taken my equation and I've rewritten it up here. To factor this part of the equation, we need to find the factors of negative 36 that sum to negative 5. These numbers are negative 9 and positive 4, so we can rewrite our middle term and factor by grouping. This gives us factors of 3x plus 2 and 2x minus 3. Now that the right-hand side of our equation is factored, we can use the zero product property and set each factor equal to 0. Solving for x in this equation, we'll get x is equal to negative 2/3, and solving for x in this equation, we'll get x is equal to 3/2. The last thing we want to do for our solution set is to make sure we check the excluded values. We know for these denominators, x cannot equal 0, or else we would have fractions that would be undefined. Since both of these values are not 0, we can rest assured that this is our correct answer.